Right, so now I want to go to Barotrauma and start it. Working. There we go. Looks like it's playing the music. I'm just not getting a preview. It's showing a black window for some reason. No, no, hold on. Nope, it's definitely showing a black window. Let me try. The titles match. This is very strange. A new source. Let's just try window capture. Hey, there we go. Is it working? Yes, it's got my cursor. Hooray! We are up and running. And I believe it is streaming to both YouTube and Twitch. As I currently have no viewers, I'm guessing if you're watching this, you're watching this on when it's been saved to video. So I will be putting an edited video up on YouTube of this. Barotrauma is a little bit gruesome, so I might have to put it under a restricted setting. It's not going to... Look, I'm still going to be doing all of the going through the Dark Souls Let's Play. This is simply a test stream just to make sure that it streams all right. So I'm going to just go for a bit of an hour on this and then just check that it's actually worked correctly. That's it. If you're watching this is Barotrauma. Now, if you haven't heard about this, it only came out a couple of weeks ago commercially. It has been around for a while. I'm not actually sure how long as a free-to-play. But the developer has decided to go commercial with it, has considerably upgraded the graphics and some of the gameplay elements to it. And this is what's been released. Now, it is still in, this is a pre-order, not pre-order, early access type game. Excuse me for a second. I just need to drink some tea. So, it is an early access game. It isn't completely done yet. What is it? It's a submarine in space game? Yeah, kind of. It's a survival game where you play a crew member on an undersea submarine on Europa. Europa is a planet that orbits Jupiter, I believe. Sorry, planet, moon, planetoid. That orbits Jupiter, one of Jupiter's moons. So it's got a methane sea under it. So the story of Barotrauma is that humans got there, they built all these undersea colonies and found that there are also some hideous monsters that live beneath the water that will, of course, try and attack you as you maneuver around the water in your submarine. Part of what makes Barotrauma fun is that there is a campaign mode to it where you go around upgrading your sub. There is also a multiplayer one where you can both play the campaign or just play random missions and try and keep your sub aloft in highly dangerous conditions. Additionally, there's also a traitor mechanic. So if they've turned it on, you can turn on in the server for there to be a traitor, and that traitor has a specific mission to carry out. Generally not to explode the sub. If people are exploding subs, they're griefers. When the game came out, it was a bit nuts. There was a lot of griefing going on. It seems to have come down a bit, and the server seemed to be pretty good on cracking down on them when they see it. So, I'm just going to go quickly through the training. I've already played through the training, but I figure I'll just go through this just to give you guys a bit of an idea. So, there are six classes. So, you've got mechanic. Your mechanic's job is to build items and to repair general mechanical structures around the ship. So your submarine will require maintenance over the course of the game. So the mechanic has to sort of just patrol around the ship repairing stuff or building new items for the ship. The engineer is sort of more of if you really want to look at this, mechanic is a mechanical engineer, the engineer is an electrical engineer. So the engineer's job is to take care of the reactor, and also to repair all wiring and maintain all wiring across the ship to make sure you've got electricity to all of your systems and power. The medic. So the medic's the one I'm going to show you in training, just because I think that the medic is one of the most interesting ways a game has done a medic before. I haven't seen it done this way before, so again, I'll go into that a little bit more when we look at it. But the medic's job is to, of course, keep everyone healed and to make medical equipment. Security officer, pretty straightforward. The security officer's job is to take care of the external guns on the ship and also keep in the armory any dangerous weaponry, that type of thing. And basically ensure general, like, there's no mutinous crews or anything like that. Take care of traitors, shoot people, that type of thing. Lastly, the captain. The captain's job is to coordinate the entire crew and drive the sub. Pilot the sub, drive the sub, pilot the sub. And navigate the sub through the water. Captain generally is informally given command over the entire vessel, so if the captain tells you to do something, you probably should do it. So, let's go in and just have a quick look at how the game runs, and then we'll go and join a multiplayer server. I admit I cannot guarantee that there won't be any harsh language in the multiplayer server. I hopefully will not get one that's that harsh, but we'll see how we go. Alright, here it is. It's a little sort of 2D thing. Ooh, ow, I've just gotten knocked over. We got some type of... Man, it's going to tell me about stuff. So this is how the game plays. So essentially, if you look, that's my character. I, with the mouse, can turn myself around. And otherwise, just backwards and forwards with the WSAD keys. You can also, like, drop into ragdoll state. There are reasons to do that. But it's more just funny. And essentially, you just click on things to do things. So I'm going to go up here, and I'm going to click on this door to open it. Always close doors behind you on submarines, just let's say, you know. I'm in a base currently, not a sub, but... So, here is how it does the medic thing, and it's quite interesting. So, essentially speaking, you've got various medical supplies. This is only the tip of the iceberg. There's like 20, I think, different medical supplies. And different injuries will require different types of healing items. So, if I press the H key, which is what they've suggested, it will tell me that afflictions are affecting the character shown in the list. Some afflictions are local to specific limbs. To treat an affliction, drag a medical item onto the highlighted area. Suggested items are shown in the interface, but caution must be exercised since some characters' medical skills aren't high enough. So essentially, how this works is, so I've got an injury to my torso. You can see there, and it is internal damage. It's light, There's an ugly shade of pebble. Gives you all the details as well. Nice immersion. And then it gives you all the things that are worthwhile. So the green things are medical items that it thinks are probably a good way of resolving the problem. So you've got opium, morphine, which is a higher degree of opium, and fentanyl, which I believe is a higher degree of morphine. And all of these ones it says is a bad thing to cure. My other areas of limb damage, it's fine. It's not really showing me anything. So it's giving me that. So if I go here and I select my morphine, and I would use it as treatment, and it will heal me up. And I'm now better. So just a quick little squiz on what's going on the screen. So these are your items. These are the items that are currently your character is wearing. This is your inventory screen. So you can have up to 10 items plus one in each hand, provided it's not a two-handed item. Up here is basically some of your communication commands. And here is your full list of crew, although there aren't any crew in this because it's a training mission. Let's go down the ladder. Do-do-do. Oh, here's a container. Oh, flashlight. There we go. Oh, I didn't know you could do that as a medic. Sometimes you've got afflictions. Follow them to the med bay. Right. I didn't know you could attach that to your medic headwear. Oh, that's awesome. So I've just gone into medic mode. So this basically is a pair of eye goggles, which if you wear, will tell you the health status of humans around you. So this guy's got 50% burns, but his oxygen level is normal, so he's not going to die of asphyxiation or anything. So we're going to tell him to follow us using these commands. So this is an AI, so if you're playing single player, this is how you deal with the AIs. So we'll walk him in here. Treat burns. Right. More medical supplies. Let's grab it all. So you can also put medical supplies in your doctor's uniform. It is a benefit of the medic that they get a container, essentially, that they can put stuff in. And that means I can keep my hands free. Alright, so we're going to... Ooh, there's more stuff. More stuff. It's here. More bandages and more bandages. Right, alright. So let's heal Rob. So it's telling me that bandages or plasticeal. Bandages are okay, but morphine is... okay-ish to heal him. So I don't have exactly what he needs, but I'm going to just use morphine on him because that should work. I didn't know for ages that you could actually scroll down here. I thought it was just the two at the top that you meant to use for ages. So morphine cures everything. It can, and interestingly enough, it's a survival game. Too much morphine can lead to addiction. And addiction on opiates, from what I've seen, tends to be a bit bad. So, this person is injured. They are essentially dead, and I've got to resuscitate them. So I'll move them over here by grabbing them. And then I will attempt to heal them. And I will hit the resuscitate button. And I will then sit on them and bump them up and down. Yeah, this probably isn't really good for YouTube. But anyway, I have successfully healed her. She is actually fully up and ready to go. There we go. And yep, here's another cabinet with stuff. Oh, I could get... So one of the interesting little things about it, you saw that little command come up there. So that's a radio signal. So you can talk via radio or talk just via talking. And if you talk via radio... It will go to everyone, based on provided you have everyone has a headset on, and otherwise it will just get talked to the people in the immediate vicinity. So it allows you to it basically allows you to hide what you're saying in some instances. So my job is to ballast tanks of the sub. It's to go and heal everyone. That's a narcotic. Wow, everyone's injured. Hey, Marjorie, come back, come back. What are you doing? You're healing. You need fentanyl or morphine, the cure for everything. Probably should use bandages. Is this a righteous indignation of the opioid crisis, maybe? Not sure. Larita Chewy also has internal damage. Morphine again. More morphine. dying from oxygen sickness. Wakey wakey. Are you still injured? Yes, you are. Look, I'll probably use some bandages. I don't want to use all my morphine. This is a training scenario. I don't think very much anything bad's going to happen. And that's our sub. Off to go. That is the basics. Let's go get into some real gameplay. So we're gonna. We don't want passwords. So no passwords. Hide the full ones. Hide the empty ones. Hide the. It's an incompatible server. So we've got scaling difficulty, auto ban. Too many evil actions could lead to kick or ban. After successful missions, difficulty increases. Script errors can only be fixed after reboot. Script loop first. All right, this one looks relatively nice. 7 out of 12. That's a decent amount of players. Latencies, pings are relatively high, but I'm from Australia, so that's normal. People tell me that's a terrible ping, and I'd go, well, I've been dealing with that.
It would, because it's like right next to the one place we're going to.
You threw in the ballast?
Oh. Oh, Joey. Young kids.
Man, you guys were clowning around.
Captain, this is a very serious matter.
This man is dead.
Yeah, that's the captain. This guy, threw him in the ballast.
Alright, the autopilot should take us where we need to go. Anyways.
So I've come midway into the game, so I've set it up to push to talk, so they won't hear me when I'm talking.
I don't think it is. I don't think you understand what I'm talking about.
We should, do a mutiny.
Sir?
Don't worry, I'm just joking.
Early access games, they do this type of thing.
I said I was joking.
I don't know why. Jesus.
I was joking.
Kill him. Oh my god.
Not sure. Alright.
Jesus.
So, they're going to talk really loudly over me, which is going to be a pain in the neck. It might just be because my sound's up. So.
You shot me.
The game will automatically download new subs. You can actually build your own submarines in this. I'm just going to turn it down for you guys because, yeah, wonderful. Young children, enjoying their day off school, I'm guessing. Possibly sick, who knows. So, up here is where you would normally change who you are, what you look like. So I've chosen this guy. He's got a cool looking goatee. It's what you always want. And here is where you would normally select what you want to do. So recently I've been playing as the medical doctor. I did play as a security for quite a while. I quite enjoyed playing as security. And I've also played as the engineer, captain, assistant. I've played as all of them before. So the assistant is the sixth class. It's essentially just... it's more for newcomers. So if you don't know what you're doing, you play as the assistant and you can do anything. You can also level up your skills as you're going. So anyway, we're just going to jump right in. So, I think I'm happy being... Am I happy being the medic? Oh, I might just go the mechanic. So, so I hit spectate. Because the game's already in progress. So when you're spectating, you'll just be able to sort of spectate. So they're trying to salvage an artifact. So these missions are kind of tricky. So, up here is the rescue shuttle. This guy has gotten stuck and will not actually be able to get back. So, if you die, and then once enough people are dead, a rescue shuttle will spawn. So see, respawn shuttle leaving in 3 minutes. So what that will mean is a new respawn shuttle will come down and be able to dock with the sub and put you off. So you don't have to sit around doing nothing forever. That said, that can be a long part of the game, particularly if people are griefing or you die due to stupidity. Which, look, will happen. It's a learning curve game. I have had lots of good games with this, though. Please don't dispute it just from what you see, because everything's going terribly. That's kind of the point. It's sort of an immersive narrative in that case. So you can see sort of the sub basic things. So there's all your fuse boxes. There are your guns. More fuse boxes. You're controlled by Dr. Adolf. Good. Herman Ronald Doctor. Okay. Yeah, let's just. Yeah. Look, Ronald's alright, I guess. I don't know about this guy. I suppose it's just the first name. Doesn't mean Alfred or something. I don't remember. All right, that's your mechanical bay. That's your reactor down there. And these are your ballast tanks, which fill up with water as the sub goes down and up, just like normal submarine physics. And the epic monkey is currently stuck. So I don't believe this will get a new respawn shuttle, because there can only be one at a time unless they've changed that. So I'm not sure what that's doing. So if I try and communicate with them as well, they won't be able to hear me because I'm currently spectating and therefore dead. So I will start to turn the audio up a little bit, just so you can hear what they're saying. So they do also have sonar, which can help them a bit. So if we look ahead, so you can sort of see this is the level design. You can look at it in spectator mode. I don't think they're going to change that. And they're going to be aiming for, there'll be, yep. So that's actually the base which they're aiming to get to, but this is the alien place that they're going to. So that's actually in a really good position, because they could just bring the sub up here. Like they could almost even dock, maybe, and just go in, get the alien artifact, which I think is that thing. No, it's that thing, I'm pretty sure. Go and get the alien artifact to come out. The alien artifact will generally be protected by a bunch of critters and so on. Can't be bad. I will be putting up a YouTube video when I get the time of Barotrauma. I have been doing a lot of recordings of Barotrauma because I played it to death when it initially came out. I must admit, I've had a lot of fun with this game. But I'm going to do, just because there is a lot of waiting around sometimes, I'm going to do a highlight stream of fun I had with Barotrauma, and there'll be some interesting little looks in that. So keep an eye out for it. So, yeah, the game itself is available. It's currently one of the more expensive early access games. I mean, I did balk a little bit at it. It was, I think, $33 Australian, which is, look, that's pretty, that's what you'd sort of hope to buy a normal game for in Australia. But that was the cost of early access. That said, I have not regretted it at all. It is a great game, and I think it shows a lot of promise. If it does fail, well, look, we've still got this little submarine simulator. That would be a bit annoying, of course, but look, that's of course the danger you go into with early access, and you just hope the product's going to be come out. The fact that these guys have done a free-to-play and been looking at that for about a year, I think, or a couple of years, they've been working on that. I think that these guys should come out with this without too many issues. And don't worry, I have been burnt on Kickstarters before and early access. I'm not going to disagree there, that it's always a bit dangerous. So yeah, you can also vote to end the round. That's if everyone's dying. So the respawn shuttle has now been destroyed. So hopefully, hopefully we are now going to respawn in a minute. So they've run out of power because someone hasn't been maintaining the reactor core. Yep. It is very much a team play game. What's a game that's similar to it? So it is compared a lot to Space Station 13, and I think that's largely because of the trader mechanic. I wouldn't call it... I have seen similar role play to what's happening. Jeez, they're going to... Then going, yep, so that's breaking into the subhole there, and they've now flooded. The reactor has exploded because they haven't been dealing with it properly, and that sub is going down. So it can hit crush depth, in which case more hull damage will occur. Worst thing is more likely that they're going to end up with critters, because creatures tend to be on these parts of the sub. Yeah, I think this is going to be a restart pretty shortly. Yep, there we go.
What the hell happened?
Got fire and exploded?
He said, shut the cuck up. He said, shut the cuck up. There was nothing there. They are really loud. All right. So while look, it's really loud in my ear. I'm not sure what it is for everyone else. I think it'll be probably pretty quiet. So I'll check that when I get out of this. So yeah, there are other games like it. So Space Station 13 is a common one. I don't think it's that much like Space Station 13. I'd say it's closer to say something like Pulsar Lost Colony. Admittedly, that doesn't have traitor mechanic, but look, that's hence the breaks. But for a board game aficionados, the best comparison is actually a little game that was done by Fantasy Flight called Red November. And it's basically a game where you are the crew of a gnomish submarine and trying to keep it afloat in hostile waters. As your gnomes can get drunk, die, and numerous other bad things happen to them, it's... some interesting things happen. Alright, so we are playing. We are playing as the engineer. So our job is to do electrical stuff. So we get a toolbox and various other things. So I've gone through. I've grabbed myself a diving mask. I'm a cautious type player. I grab stuff that's important to me. So I'm also going to grab a welding tool and a crowbar. Because trust me, that's always useful to have. So, I'm just going to talk to this guy for a second. Dr. Snafu, do you want to manage the reactor rods? Or do you want me to? Strange. Maybe my mic's being used by this, so it can't be used. All right. Let's grab some bandages. So this is how the reactor works. So you can stick it on automatic, which is what he's done. So essentially you put a fuel rod in and then it outputs a certain amount of energy. You basically got to keep the two things here in the green. Otherwise bad stuff happens, like the reactor catches a light and explodes. On auto, it should never do that unless you put in too many fuel rods. So at the moment, there's actually less power than what's required. So a lot of people often recommend putting in two fuel rods and then managing it manually, but you sort of just gotta do what you need to do. So I did grab myself a welding torch as well to help weld the deck. I find that that's always useful to have. The diving mask will give me some basic oxygen supply if I need it, but it will not protect me against pressure damage. You need a diving suit for pressure damage. Down here. Oh, that's right. This is this bay. The welding torch also acts as a weapon. that one. Alright, off to the rescue. I've got to go and seal all these hull, because it's basically cracked the hull there. I probably can't completely get everything, but I can at least start. I've been crushed by water pressure. Go me. Yeah, we're too deep. Too deep. Gave a good go. I think I nearly repaired everything. So, those type of damage will allow water to seep in. When you make your own submarine, it will explain how the game does this a little better. It's quite intelligent. It is actually quite intelligent. And here we have mud raptors. So these little jerks have swum around and attacked the ship. They've clawed on board and managed to break through the hull right there. That's a huge hull opening. That's another hull opening where they've clawed their way through, opened through that door. I think they've also clawed their way through there. So they are causing massive problems. And water is now flooding into the ship. So, we're barely anywhere. See, the thing is as well, because once you die, you can't say anything. If you haven't advised what's going on, it could be that no one knows what's happening, and you're suddenly left with a sub, and you're going, hey, is anyone still alive? Hello? And everyone's been murdered, or by a mud raptor or something. So that mud raptor is eating him. So he's stuck because the security officer needs to open the thing and no one's listening to him. If you're thinking this is a terrible game because of this type of thing, well, look, if you're not going to enjoy this type of madcap gameplay, then you're probably not going to enjoy this game. I'm going to be perfectly honest. It's kind of similar to Dwarf Fortress a little bit as well, except you can talk to the dwarves and tell them that they're being twats. Well, these guys are bad. So he's got a harpoon gun. Now, water is now going all through the sub. It thankfully will not drop any lower, but it will continue dropping if it does have holes in it. So these guys are trying to... That one can only dock from the bottom. Interesting. Has to dock up there. Oh, I suppose the other one... No, the other one is a bottom dock. Whoa. What was that? So that mud raptor is going to eat... So, I think he's hitting it with a stun baton, which is stunning it, which is probably... Why isn't he killing it? No! No, Rommel! Go back and finish it off! You fool! That raptor is about to get up and murder everyone. Unless they've knocked it out. So, oh, maybe they've sedated it or something. The neurotoxin it. Yeah, it's dying slowly. I think they've hit it with some sort of poison. Oh, no. Is it? Yep, it's back. It's back. There it goes. So it's clearly bleeding to death. It must have blood loss. I think maybe the pistol shot wounded it. I don't know why he's not finishing it off. So anything in this can be used as a weapon. And realistically speaking, I've found over time that generally it doesn't matter what class you are, get a weapon. Get a weapon and get a wrench, crowbar, or better yet, a welding torch. Anything will save your life sometimes. These guys are so stuffed. I don't know why. What is he doing? Simply stopping everyone from spawning. So when flooded compartments will also cause damage to the components inside. So the more flooded compartments you have, the more damage is going to be caused across the sub over time. We can't actually see the damage in spectator mode. I'm actually probably going to vote to end round here because I think that this is a bit ridiculous where it's currently sitting. So thankfully that sub has finally it's still there. Now it's returning. So the rescue sub will automatically return. It will go and then return. So you've only got a limited time to get to the sub. So there is a bit of an issue with that. And I think it's something they're probably going to look into for development, or at least I hope they do, which is that often if the big sub is quite far ahead, the rescue sub will often not have a chance to get to it. Particularly as a lot of people prefer to stick the rescue sub on autopilot, and autopilot is a lot slower than manually piloting it. Or autopilot also occasionally crashes into rocks. It's not that great, but people piloting the sub often can crash into rocks themselves. It is a bit... piloting the sub is a bit whippy. It's physics-based, so it's not stop on a dime. So if you've got inertia going one direction, you've got to turn it around. My connection has timed out. That's not good. Stream looks like it's still going, so could not connect to server. Okay, cool. I've been kicked or something. Alright, so that's over. So we've got the dankest server. That's interesting. Discord, BT Public, so that's the classic City and Me Epic Gamer moments. So it looks like that server has actually gone down. So this one definitely has traitor. So there's Discord, the city state of Singapore. Look, we'll just go to BT Public. Hopefully, not service full. Let's go refresh. Sorry, empty servers as well. Might as well. So a lot of people appear to be putting on password protection these days. Entire state of San Francisco. Drunk Punk's clever server name. Alright, what can we do? Why don't we create a server? Let's play a new game. I'll show you the campaign mode. Because that server has died. It's the Klink Hammer, my sub. It doesn't work very well. It's a bit crap. yes, it doesn't work. I haven't set the wiring up correctly, so the sub basically collapses like a stone. Iron Gear. Deep Dives RP server. That's pretty interesting. Ocean Gear, the SI Coil. So there's shuttles. The Ocean Glider. Dangerous Oceans of Europe. Okay. Mercury 2, also made for an RP server. Oh, look at that thing. That's huge. 3 to 14? 3? Typhon. A lot of people like the Typhon. It's got a lot of guns. I mean, it's got a heavy rail gun and two regular guns. I think, though, the Remora is probably the most experienced sub. It's a bit tricky to use. It's got like a... It's got a little, a drone thing on the front of it. The Orca, which is the one we had a look at just before. The Humpback. The Humpback is kind of small, but I think it's actually got... Oh, that's right. It's got a pretty terrible velocity, I think. And the Dugon is just a basic sub. So look, we're just going to jump on board the... Look, why not? We'll just use the Dugon. I mean, I don't like the Dugon. It's the initial starting sub. But we'll just have a look at it, just to have a look at how the game works. So this is basically how it works. So there's a campaign map. And you've got these various areas. And each area is ranked by danger by the color. So green areas are friendly areas. Yellow areas are unknown. And red areas are nasty. So, so essentially, if I was to go here, this is a colony, so I can actually buy stuff at the store. I can also hire crew. This is how much money I have. Crew are expensive, it looks like. So we've got a captain, an engineer, and a mechanic. I'm Lucas Hoffman. So you will actually move around these people when you're playing in single player. So assistants are relatively cheap. I could get an assistant and then maybe train them up to do something. That might be an idea. I can repair my sub, or I can go to the store and purchase important components. So, always a good idea to have a couple of extra fuel rods, I think. That's probably not a bad idea. I like having guns. I am a big fan of having extra revolvers because they do a lot of things. Welding tools. We should be right. The sub will come with a lot of stuff itself. It's not like you don't get anything. But I think that's a few fuel rods and some revolvers. I think that's pretty good. I might just get some... how much is uranium? 50. Steel bars are 25. So I can also make fuel rods myself using those two ingredients. So I might as well get some of that. Crew, I will grab Harlan Meester, who seems to be really okay. So this is what I was talking about, skills. So he's got some very basic skills in mechanical engineering, electrical engineering. I don't know what the trait does. Weapons, medical, helm, and initiative. So his initiative's crap. He's laid back. Well, that's probably why. I can look at these guys. So Lucas Hoffman, my captain, is helm 79, weapons 48. So all those skills will give you successes at being able to do stuff. Now, you don't need the skill to do a job. You can do anything you want in this game. It's literally, you can try and do it, doesn't matter what, and your skill will go up depending on what it is. So, wow, that's a cool initiative. Price. All right. So the AI, from what I found, is generally all right. It's sometimes not perfect because sometimes it won't do things that a player would normally do. Like a player would happily, like as you saw me do, swim into a flooded compartment to try and stop the ship from going down, which I was mildly successful at. But they would not do it at all. Like I should have gone and got a diving suit. I didn't because I thought I'd be okay. But they won't even go and get a diving suit. You've got to still do that yourself. Alright, so we can do a mission over there, which is salvaging an artifact. We could do a mission here, which is a medical item transport. Let's just do a nice little, an easy transport mission. Someone's got morbacine poisoning. You might stand a chance of survival if you can get a shipment of antidote by them, and you'll be paid 700 credits on delivery. Alrighty. Purchase supplies have been delivered to a midships. So I'm a captain. Captain! Yeah. So what that means is the supplies that we purchased are all here. So if I click that, and I look in here, I will find all of this stuff. So I'm going to take this down to the reactor. I'm going to tell you to repair damaged systems. I'm going to tell you to operate the reactor, power it up. Lucas Hoffman, Harlan Meester. Harlan Meester can just wander around and fix leaks, I think. It's probably the best option for him. Alrighty, so I'm going to drop this box. So the box is a big item, so I have to carry it in two hands. I'm just going to get... I forgot to buy ammo for my guns. Oh, boy. So we're going to stick these rods in here. I'm going to grab a screwdriver myself. The thing is with single player is you probably want to be getting your skills up yourself as well, because again, the AI crew are decent, but they're not gods. They are not super intelligent by any means. I don't know whether that's going to get better with development or not. I think I purchased items to make stuff with, and then I've chosen the sub which doesn't have a buildable thing. I think if there's one thing about that streaming the last and starting this channel over the last week has shown me is that my absent-mindedness is really bad. I forget stuff all the time. Or I'm just an idiot. One of the two. Ooh, it's got a syringe gun. Get a syringe gun. No, I don't need a syringe gun. So I've got a welder. I've got a few little bits of bobs. That's probably fine. Let's get moving. So I'm going to jump on this. This is the Captain's Command console. So this gives you an overview of the sub. So that's got but just slightly worse air quality than everywhere else. And allows you to tell people around that things are happening. So I'm going to click the undock button. So here is my sonar. Now what I want to do is I want to change to active sonar so I can actually see. Bing. But that will of course create a pinging sound, which can mean that other people can hear me. So I'm going to undock. Boop. And I'm just going to hit autopilot to say Sue Station and just see what that does. Autopilot is generally a safer way of traveling, but it can lead to stupidity when the ship decides to do stupid things. It's generally a bit safer just because it is very easy to increase your velocity down one way and then have not enough time to stop. We'll do it for a bit and then I might pilot it in a little bit as we get a bit further on. Oh, what the hell, you only live once. Basically, how piloting works is you click it in the arrow and the distance you do with the arrow will indicate how fast the sub will travel. If you are traveling one direction, though, you need to, of course, go back the other direction to slow your movement because that's how inertia works. So a very slight angle upwards will of course slowly remove your moving downwards. So I've got what looks to be a shoal of fish here. It doesn't look to be particularly big. Those are a bit bigger though. Hopefully they're nothing bad. So I can see what I'm aiming for over here, Sesu Station. 10XP, I don't know what that was for. Going to tell him to go. Where's repair electrical systems? Yeah, just tell him to repair damage systems as well. If the reactor doesn't blow up. This is a green zone, so it's likely to be relatively safe. Actually, I think I know what I'm getting XP for manning the helm because I'm actually manning it manually. So that is a reason to do it. Yeah, there we go. Helm's increased to 80. This is been a relatively safe voyage. It's a good start. Good start. At this point, I'm just going to go to autopilot because it's just safer. So how you dock is you essentially just, you maneuver these two green things up against one another and then you hit the docking button. Is it going to be smart enough to do it? Yeah, I think it might be. It's a bit iffy. Bit iffy. Yep, need to go back that way for a bit. So you can sort of issue some commands while the autopilot's on, and it'll and then once you've got the two green things aligned, it should hit the docking button. No, need to go a bit further across. Docking. There we go. And we're docked. And I can now exit. And we should have succeeded in our mission. I did actually bring them. Did I have to actually pick up the medical supplies from the place? Oh no, we're good. We succeeded. So I get some credits, and then I can just go do something. So I just want to see. No, it's still salvaging an artifact. I can go. No, I can't go over there. So you can just do no mission, and that'll just get you to the area. Oh, here we go. Killing a Moloch. All right. Molochs are hard. They are big critters. We'll probably die, but that's fine. Let's go. We'll go do a hunt. 5,000 credits. I mean, who wouldn't do that? Terminator Swarm is probably harder in some respect because there's basically got to take out the little bugs who can get on board your ship. Molochs are giant jellyfish things with big, hardened, crusty heads. And I think this will be a nice end of the stream. I hope this has been a reasonably good test. If you are watching the save video of this, I know it is saving to Twitch. I know that should be working. So if you're watching this on Twitch, I hope this has been a good stream. If you are watching on YouTube because it's worked on YouTube, thanks very much. And yeah, we'll see how we go. All right, so let's power up the reactor. I'm going to put you on repairing damaged systems. I'm going to put you on operating the weaponry. So coil gun or coil gun, fire at will. Yep, fire at will. There we go. All right. Let's do this. So there is the Moloch. It is at 490 meters down. I should probably... Oh no, active zone is on. Yeah, it sort of it saves all your equipment and so on in between missions on the campaign mode, which is cool. Makes life pretty easy. Here we go. So I suppose the question is, do you play this game for single player or multiplayer? And the thing is, I can say is you can play it for both. Multiplayer I find is a little bit more fun because, again, you can play with your friends and whatever. I've been trying to get my friends into playing this game, but of course, I'm getting there, working on it slowly. So that's the plan anyway. So after he's done that, I'm going to get him on the front turret. Can I put him on? Yeah, there we go. Operate weapons, fire at will. Nope. Right, there is the Moloch. So my weapons are all on the bottom of this sub, so I want to be engaging it from above. That could be a little bit tricky, but we're going to see how we go. Yeah, it's going to be really tricky. It's going to be bad. Yeah, I've also got a gun on the front, that side, though, so I might be alright. Okay, there's the Moloch. It's coming at us. It's coming right for us. Yep, we're firing at it. You can hear the guns roaring, and that is the Moloch punting us in the air with its mighty head. You can probably... Ow! Alright, so that has knocked us all for six air. We are now leaking. Fix leaks. So, first things first is grab a diving suit in this type of situation. So I'm not going to drown now. Now, let's see. I'll get back on the... See, we're probably sinking like a stone. I'm not even sure there's anything I can do. On here, yeah. Look at all the compartments filled with water. Yeah, you just keep shooting, dude. You just keep shooting. It's literally me and that other guy left. Everyone else is unconscious or dead. Let's get everything back running as fast as I can. Man, that thing is hitting us. If we come close to death, I might try and actually go out and get you an idea of what it looks like. But I think we're in trouble. Yeah, it is just banging the life out of us at the moment. There's very little I can do to stop it. How's this? Okay, cool. The reactor is... Right. So the reactor room is actually kind of fine. Yeah, you need to fix leaks. Maybe we're okay. Maybe, nope, we are not okay. And I'm now unconscious. So there's not much I could do. If a crew member can get to me, I'd normally be okay. But I'm going to give in for the moment and die. And I will now go back to... I thought I played as Mariko Parker now. Oh, unconscious. Right. So can I spectate? No, apparently I can't spectate. So yeah, there was a massive hull opening up there. There's the Moloch up there. Look at the size of him. He is a big critter. I very much doubt we really did much damage to him. Normally you would not try and take this out with an orca. This sub is really undergunned for taking on something like that. You really need a rail gun. You can take him out with coil guns, but you need a pretty good crew. And look, that thing just nailed us. Look at him snuffling around. He's just going to keep hammering the sub until it cracks. But everyone, I believe, is dead. My poor sub. Yeah, it's cracked open through there, cracked open through there. Repairing that did halt some of it, but reopening that was not a smart move. And look, all of this is now broken and busted. The reactor's still going fine. Like, all of this is not underwater. That bit's fine. The reactor will eventually run out of power because the rod will go out. I don't know why Mariko Parker hasn't done anything. And there's the power going out because the reactor rod's down. Mariko Parker is now dead. And everyone is dead. Died of internal injuries, crushed by water pressure. Yeah. Those guys just didn't get a chance to put on a diving suit. Though the two of us did. Both died from internal injuries from getting knocked around. So, that is a great little ending to Barotrauma. That's why it's called Barotrauma. Crushed by internal injuries. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you're watching it, and I am going to stop the stream now and going to go check to make sure this worked correctly. And if it worked correctly, it means when I do my part 3 of Dark Souls, it will be on both YouTube and Twitch, and I will not need to try and upload the video. I am still going to upload the Dark Souls video I did last night to YouTube. It's just it's taking a while. The video quality of it is so high. I've had a lot of trouble getting it into a workable condition to upload to YouTube. I could just upload the base video that's on Twitch. My only concern with that is I prefer to cut it down. There's about a 30-minute window there where I had to take a phone call, so it's a bit boring. And I left my mic on, so all you can, they've got no music either. So all you can really hear is just a muffled sound of me talking to someone. So it's not particularly interesting, that bit. And the last hour is literally me dying to skeletons over the course of an hour again and again and again. If you enjoy that, certainly the video is on Twitch. I will be uploading it to YouTube eventually once I can get it to export correctly from my video editor. So thanks for watching, guys. Thank you for watching the world of Klink. I am your host, Colonel Klink, signing off.